So the big question lately a lot of people are asking is, I've been watching your stories, you've been talking about these food shortages, and if you haven't seen those, go back and look, but basically if this is brand new to you and you didn't know, you know, the borders being shut down is a major problem for food coming in. There's no migrant workers to pick food. Everybody's panic buying. You combine those three things, and then the farmers aren't growing food this summer. A lot of them are, because they don't have anyone to pick it. You put all that together and you got like a perfect storm for a food shortage. So the issue is, well, when's it coming? Because right now, if you go out in the supermarkets, everybody got the government money checks, and they are, you know, they're going out and buying stuff, and the shelves are mostly restocked. Although where I'm at out in the country, you can't find rice, beans, flour, none of that stuff's around, but everything else is really well restocked. I think you got to understand, we will have, like, it'll look good for about a few weeks. People will be like, okay, economy's moving again, restrictions are lifting, stuff's getting back to normal. And they kind of have to prop that illusion up because it's not real. What's going to happen is these boats that usually bring us food, some of them didn't even leave. And some of them aren't even being allowed out of their countries. There's certain countries that are like, well, we're worried about our food supply. Yeah, you're not shipping that to the U.S. Like, I don't know if you realize that the U.S. Imports a lot of wheat from China and Russia. We don't even grow that much wheat that we keep. So, you know, those kind of things are really going to affect what's coming in as far as the staples go. I was married to a woman who did logistics at the ports. So that means they tracked how ships come in and how they bring stuff into the country. So I kind of learned a little bit about just-in-time shipping and things like that, where, you know, the food arrives just in time so you can eat it and go. But what was really surprising to me is that term, a slow boat from China, is a real thing. That some of these boats would take 6 weeks to 2 months to bring stuff over. I had no idea it took that long. So if these borders are shut and we start running out of food and we're counting on people to ship food in, there's going to be at least a 6 week to 2 month gap where things just aren't coming in. So I think what's going to happen is that's going to start arriving in the next few weeks. It'll look really good for a bit. And then you'll start noticing, okay, you know, I've been asking when the rice is going to come back, and it's not coming back. That it's just not showing up anymore. And the grocery store is just going to start running out of restocking things. It won't be all at once. But what will happen is eventually some sort of news story is going to pick it up and push it out that there's a food shortage. And when that hits, people are going to go rush out, panic buy whatever's left. And then for about 2 to 3 months, when that, because the shipping's so disrupted, there's going to be very little pickings at the stores. And what will happen is, even though this country has food reserves, it's safe for like regional disasters, things like hurricanes. It's not designed to feed an entire country. And most of the time it goes to the military. So, you know, the military and the police and whatever the services, they get food, but not you. So don't count on, you know, food coming. What will happen is when the food banks start running out and the stuff's not really being restocked in the store well, people will panic buy the day it comes in. They'll just be following the trucks. And we'll go through a month or two, I think, of where it's really just hard to get food. And what that will do is unfortunately create a mentality where people start getting very angry and dangerous and scared, where, you know, they're pushing each other in the stores over toilet paper, that sort of thing. I think that will happen for a while, because even after this 2 or 3 month period where they're trying to get food back on the shelves, when it arrives, it's going to instantly be bought out, which is going to create another problem for food won't be there for another 2 weeks. And then that'll instantly be bought out, and that'll be instantly bought out. And that'll keep going until enough confidence builds that, okay, the food supply is back to normal and it's coming in. So it might be a couple months where you're really fighting to get, you know, a couple cans of corn or something. I think that's the scenario that's going to go down. I don't want to be scary and sad about it, but I do, with all these things going on at once, they're trying to put out that, okay, everything's back to normal, go back to work, it's cool. But that's not reality, because there's a huge storm of stuff coming that is not being talked about. And when it starts getting talked about in the mainstream media, it's too late. Like, there's a couple articles. I did that one about the UN warning and one of the senators saying, hey, it's coming. But really what you need to be doing right now is stocking up on what you can find. I know I've been yelling at you about stocking up, but trust me, who knows how long it's going to go? People could, like, lose their damn minds for 6 months or a year, you know, scrounging, or the economy could really take a hard collapse because of something. Just get ready for, like, worst case, and then if it doesn't happen, big deal. You got a bunch of rice, and you bought it before the inflation hit. So either way, it's a smart thing to do. You're either buying food that's as low price as it's going to be, because the prices are going to go up. It's already happening, if you noticed, in the stores. Maybe even stock up on a little gasoline, that sort of thing. But right now, everybody's calm and cool, and they're going out and spending their checks. Like, if you look at this, I thought for sure when the $1,200 check would run out, like, the first thing people would do is stock their food shelves. And instead, they're, like, buying stupid stuff. They didn't learn anything. Like, look at this article. They're buying sex toys and, well, I mean, I get that you probably need those if you're going to be at home for 6 months. But, you know, they're buying stuff that really isn't going to be key to survival, you know, feeding their family. So the writing's on the wall. There's a lot of people that aren't going to be prepared worth a damn. Please continue to stock up, and most importantly, grow a garden. Control your own food supply a bit. And I know some of you guys are like, well, I'm an apartment, or I live in a shady place that I can't do anything about. And, you know, you can still grow in containers, and I'll teach you how to do a little bit of that and start it. But if you guys have grass and lawns, you don't need lawns. Go make gardens before it's too late. You're still plenty of time to put a garden in the ground. Please go back and look at my other videos. They'll teach you how to make an emergency potato patch. That is where you want to start. That's your best bang for the buck. And then you can make a couple, like I'm doing, a couple little gardens that will grow some accessories. You know, some nutrients, some vegetables, some greens and squash and stuff like that. And I'll probably double my potato garden eventually, because it's not enough to live on. If absolutely, you know, it goes to hell, it's not enough to live on. But it is enough to get me through a few months of winter. So please focus on those things and start taking it serious, because everything's going to be happy for a little bit. But it's just a lull. It's not real. There's too much economic damage that's already happened for this thing to bounce back normally. Okay? So don't be fooled by it. Go out and stock up while you can get it and it's out there. And again, focus on the staples. A lot of my friends say they can still get stuff at the ethnic stores. Like, some of my friends were saying, oh yeah, they got rice all over the Asian stores. It's good. Go buy some, you know, 50-pound bags, stock up on them. Do that while you can get them, because I really think we're still, what, maybe 6 weeks into this thing, maybe 2 months. So there's still all those old boats that left that are arriving, and things are still being stocked on the shelves. But that's going to stop soon, and it's not going to be on the shelves like it used to be. And I don't think it's coming back for a while. So, again, I'm not trying to panic you guys. I'm trying to inform you to wake up so you can do something proactive and feel good and have some security. Don't just sit there and watch the news and freak yourself out. Go out and start a garden. That's a really positive thing to do that makes you feel good about controlling your own life. All right, I love you guys. Stay in there. Oh, one other thing, obviously, I'll show you a little garden update. Oh, I hurt my foot really. Oh God, I'm hurting myself like an old man the last few years. It's ridiculous. You know, I used to play rugby where we could, it'd be like getting in a 6 car wrecks every game. You know, you get up and you'd be fine the next day, where now every little thing hurts you. And that's a problem on, you know, maybe we should talk about that someday with homesteading. What do you do when you get hurt? And I dropped a mug on my foot, and my other foot now, you know, I broke that one foot really bad a few years ago that I remember some of you guys on the channel saw, and it just crippled me. And now this other foot. So it's put my gardening to a halt. All I can really do, I think, maybe is just get some seeds ready. I can't really dig or drag anything around the yard. So I haven't really got much done in the yard, unfortunately, because of the injury. So I'll show you what I did. So before I hurt myself, I've got this old bed now extended and chipped. Still got a little weeding to do, but waiting for my foot to heal. I will say, look at this. So these are bunching onions that I left alone for a few years. I never picked them. And they are coming up so early. And the chives, these are called chive turkeys. They're not really, but I really want them to be called chive turkeys. And here's some garlic chives. So the onions and the chives, that sort of stuff is coming out pretty quick. I've got to get in here and also do, got another bed here, I got a weed, and it's not too bad. It's not nearly as bad as the other one, but the edges are bad just because of the same issue. I didn't drop enough cardboard when I set them up. So we're gonna fix that. But the trees are starting to come out, like the peach trees, starting to go. And also remember that I'm trying to get off YouTube. If you go over to BitChute or Brighton, you can sign up over there and get these stories earlier. They arrive about a day or two earlier than YouTube. I'll still put them on YouTube if you just don't want to do that, but I'm trying to get off YouTube, and you know, YouTube stopped paying me pretty much almost completely. So what I'm gonna have to do to make up the difference is I wish you guys would use the Amazon links. If you're gonna buy something on Amazon for your garden, please go through my link first. The way it works is don't go to Amazon, fill your cart, and then come back through the link. It doesn't work like that. You have to like go through my link first, go buy your Amazon stuff, and buy it within the same day. And then I get a little cut, and it doesn't cost you anything. It's a free way to help me and the show. The other thing is I'm selling my woodwork just to try to keep things afloat because my practice is pretty much shut down. So if you guys can help out, you want a piece of wood, let me know. Thanks. Love you guys. Hang in there. Bye.